Aquarius, what's up, loves? Welcome to Black Madonna HP's Table Etiquette, where I'm about to get all in you guys' business. Something has been going on with your energy that's so significant. It has changed dramatically since I last did your reading, so I'm curious to find out what it is, Aquarius. But you guys, make sure you check out Black Madonna HP. You'll find some pretty beautiful clothing items. I got a couple of collections, the Gold Rush collection, the Black and White Luxe collection, and the Red Crush collection. The Red Crush is gonna kill them for Valentine's Day, so you definitely wanna ensure that you check out my clothing website and see what's up. But either way, let's go ahead, hop into this reading and see the message that Beloved has for you. What has changed with Aquarius since my baby, since I've been gone? What is up with these Aquariuses? Ten of Pentacles. Wow, why am I getting "I only want you to love"? That's what's changed. This person has realized that they messed up with Aquarius. Let's see what's up. What's going on for Aquarius, please? What's the message? Too many cards at once, Beloved. One at a time, please. Thank you. What's going on for Aquarius, please? Ew. Oh, they don't got their mind right, Aquarius, I see. But you ain't feeling them. Wow. Wow. Yeah, you haven't forgot the damage that was done. You haven't forgot how harsh they could be. You haven't forgot who this person truly is. Let's see what's up. You have the King of Pentacles, the Five of Pentacles, the Eight of Cups, ooh-wee, the Queen of Cups, the Page of Pentacles, the Chariot, the Three of Wands, the Emperor, the Three of Cups, the Sun, the Queen of Swords, the Ten of Cups, the Seven of Cups, the Six of Swords, and the Seven of Pentacles. The reason why I'm laughing, why is it always this scenario that you don't miss a good thing till it's gone, or you know, you don't appreciate the finer things in life until you no longer have them? And that's what I'm getting. I'm getting like a person that settled for McDonald's or something, and they could have had like a great steak meal, or you understand what I'm saying? Like quality over quantity type ordeal. This was a person that liked it variety, right? They like to feed their ego. They like to feed off of other people, but they were getting McDonald's meals when they had a steak buffet at their fingertips. So now that your energy has shifted, now that your mind has changed, now they want the steak meal, but it's like you're so focused on you now, right? Like you've taken your losses. And you're like, you know what? I'm just going to focus on me. I'm going to focus on loving me. Because I see what you were doing. You were giving all your energy, time, attention, and affection to this person. And this person was depleting you, leaving you with nothing to give to yourself. You felt in a lot of different ways the abandonment issues. I don't know if this person came to your life to help you deal with the abandonment issues, but you definitely don't have them now, right? But to be in a Page of Pentacles energy, energy of lack, energy of please help me, energy of, you know, I don't have what I need to sustain. This was your energy towards this person because you loved them so much. You didn't mind giving yourself to them. But I see there this was the shift I was feeling. This shift was profound in your life. Something gave you the strength, the resilience, the ability to finally ask for what you deserve or leave a situation that you didn't deserve to be in. Because I see that this person is now in this King of Pentacles energy. Now they're wanting to do the right thing. Now they've matured. Now they've grown up. Now they feel the need to build a foundation with Aquarius, who is very rare, because you know Aquarius, I'm so used to eating McDonald's. I thought that was real beef, but I didn't know that they had USDA grade beef. I didn't know that they had, I forgot what that beef is called. It started with the A. But I didn't know, is it Angus beef? I didn't know that there was different type of beef. I don't think it was Angus, but it's a top tier beef. But this person had gotten used to McDonald's. I don't know why I keep getting that that analogy. But it was something about someone settling for less, because that's what they felt like they deserved. They never felt like they truly deserved you and the love that you gave to them. You gave them something that was so significant in their life. I feel like it scared them, because they never felt this level or intensity of the way that they loved you. So this person took you for granted. They were in their narcissistic energy, okay? They wanted their cake and eat it too, or they wanted their McDonald's and you too. But see, when you eat McDonald's, it fulfills you, but it's not fulfilling for you. It's not good for you, the quality. You know, like when you consider, like I keep talking about quality over quantity. When you consider, like you could go and with your steak, you're going to have a beautiful baked potato, you know, with maybe sour cream and onions and all that type of stuff, right? But this person was having French fries, and their French fries had 33 different ingredients in it just to make a fry. Like, so these are people that they were dealing with, different people, random people that had, you know, all of this fictitious things added to them. You know, like you show up authentically yourself, you show up authentically you, but this person was having a ball with these people that don't even, and I hate to say it like this, but don't even compare to you. Like you a real, I don't know if it's because I'm cooking or if you guys are cooking or what these food analogies are about. But it's like, when you got a real potato, why would you settle for 33 additional ingredients of things? Like I said, quality over quantity. Yeah, you may get more fries. You may, you know, they may have the looks, you know, the breast augmentation, the ass, the long lashes, the, you know, whatever. They might have all of these things to make them seem and appear like they something more than they are, but they're not. Take all that shit off and get down to it and talk to them and find out who they are, and you'll see that there's no substance to these people, right? But for some odd reason, this is what a person wanted to settle for in their life at that time. But you know what? Something in their heart, they knew who was real, who was authentic. Why do I feel like they always knew, like, who you were to them, or what you meant to them, or your value, or your worth? They just, you know, really hoped, Aquarius, that you didn't see it. Because the day that Aquarius find out that I'm not who I appear to be, and that I don't have the substance that I appear to have, Aquarius isn't gonna want me. Aquarius can do better than me. But you know what? As long as Aquarius allow me to, I'm going to show up however I want to towards Aquarius. When I come towards Aquarius, I might show up nice. I might show up mean. I might show up giving. I might show up as an asshole. I might show up as the narcissist. I might show up as a magician. I might show up as a dark magician. Whatever Aquarius allow for me to show up as, that's what I'm going to show up as. Because I can never show Aquarius my true authentic self. Because Aquarius isn't going to want me if I show up as my true authentic self. You know, that's why I need my variety of people. That's why I need to keep moving, you know, so Aquarius doesn't find out the true nature of who I am. Because as long as I can keep projecting to Aquarius this fantasy of what we can be, what we could be, as long as I let Aquarius think that I'm their knight in shining armor or I'm their, you know, everything, then I can always have Aquarius in my life. Because if Aquarius ever find out and see me for who I truly am and what I truly stand for, Aquarius will want nothing to do with me. And why do I feel like that day has came, Aquarius? I feel like this was the profound shift that I was picking up at the beginning of the reading. Like you found out who this person really was. You found out that the person you thought that you knew, you never knew this person at all. This person just put on different masks for you and wore all these different people, whatever they needed to be at the time you needed them to be it. That's who they were. Huh. That's so interesting. So we got the Queen of Wands, the King of Cups, the Two of Cups, the Ten of Swords. Two more, please. Yeah. That's funny. That's funny. They never wanted you to know who they truly were because they don't even know, Aquarius. They're still trying to figure out who they are. I don't know who the hell I am. So, you know, for Aquarius, I just keep showing up whatever way I can show up for Aquarius. So Aquarius will never know who I really am. As long as I just show up differently, every time Aquarius see me, Aquarius won't go anywhere. Aquarius, this person who you don't know, who you think you know, but you really don't know, but you have this strong connection with, is ready to settle down with you in this childlike state. But you know what's crazy? As you're being advised not to, to reject this offer. I'm not sure why. I have to rewind that. Why? Right? I know why. Because you don't know who this person truly is. They show up however they need to show up. So you'll never find out who they truly are. This person wrestles a lot. They still have a lot of things that they need to work on. They need to find out who they truly are instead of just showing up. Because they just show up. This is why they stick and move. This is why you was dealing with that Knight of Wands energy. Why is this person always in and out of my life? Why is this person like, why don't they ever stay with me? Like, what's wrong with me? What's wrong with me? And beloved is like Aquarius. It's not you, beloved. I know you got this strong connection with this person. And you are always there when they need you to be. Right? But the problem you're having is you're dealing with a person. I don't know if this person has multiple personality disorders. I'm not sure if they have bipolar. But one thing I'm certain of is this person never shows up the same. When they come to you, there, you never know what to expect, right? Their attitude is unpredictable. You don't know it when they show up, if they're going to show up at this beautiful person that's giving and loving and kind, or they showing up as this mean ass emperor that's, you know, they want it their way. Why didn't you do what I asked you to do? You know, you don't know if they're showing up, you know, feeling like having sex and feeling sexy. You just don't never know, huh? Never know how this person is going to show up. But you dealt with it for as long as you could, Aquarius. Okay. Let's see, what else does Aquarius need to know about this person? That was such a fake laugh. I could tell this person be faking. I swear, I don't know what's up with that fake laugh lately. But I'm going to tell you why I laughed. A two-faced friend. A cat. So that you never know what you're going to get with this person. A stubborn, aggressive person. You don't know if they gonna treat you like shit and be like, I'm down with you. I ain't messing with you no more. You don't know if they, baby, you know, let's settle down. Let's be together. Let's chill. You know, you don't know if they gonna come. You know, I want to have everything with you. You the person I want, Aquarius. You don't know if they gonna come in, you know, with this victory-like mindset and they gonna be talking about money and they need you to help them. You know, can you help me with something, Aquarius? I need your help. Can you write this proposal? Can you, you don't know if they coming in, like I said, needing your help. You don't know if they coming in broke or rich. You just never know, Aquarius. Here you go, February. I see that things are getting ready to work out for you. But yeah, you gonna hurt over letting this person go. But you just never know. This is a unpredictable as person. You never know, Aquarius, what you gonna get. But I do see also, if they're gone right now, you might see them again in February. But your person is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you gonna get. Let's go ahead and get your message closed out this reading. I swear to goodness, Forrest Gump. So does this person have a mental disability, Aquarius, that you're aware of? Huh. Wow. This reading wore me out, Aquarius. I'm breathing like, beloved, what's the message you have for Aquarius? Medicine mother, honor your inner knowing. You already know. And why are you showing up as the medicine mother? Because you've been trying to help this person. You're always trying to help this person. This person needs help from God, from source, from spirit, whatever you guys call them. Definitely my God, though. But you're always trying to nurse this person. But listen to your intuition, because you're being told to not help this person and to allow them to go to the Most High for deliverance, because they need it. Okay? But either way, Aquarius, this is the message I have for you, you guys. I thank you guys so much for tapping into Black Madonna HP. Don't forget to check out blackmadonnahp.com. Definitely got some fly clothes over there, so you definitely want to check that out. Also, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, love, peace, and so take care.